What do you guys think of when I talk about Archer? Hypixel Skyblock is an amazing game for a lot of reasons: balanced weapons, amazing community, and great moderation. But in all seriousness, it's a great game that you and I are addicted to. In July 7th, 2020, dungeons were added to Hypixel Skyblock. It was one of the biggest updates to this day, and it changed how we play the game dramatically. We for once got something challenging, something we cannot one-shot or breeze through. Before getting into the video, only a small percentage of you guys are actually subscribed, so it will mean the world to me if you would like and subscribe. Also, my Discord is linked in the description if you want to chat with me, and yeah, let's go back to the rise and fall of the Archer class. People played all sorts of classes during the start of the update, but everyone slowly transitioned to using Mage. Mage is extremely powerful due to the sheer clearing power and the damage output of the Bonzo staff. In other words, Mage was the best of all worlds. You had the damage output of a Berserker or an Archer, but still had crazy mass clearing powers. Almost everyone slowly shifted away from Archer and started playing Mage. This lasted until the release of Catacombs 4.4, where Boomerangs are introduced. If you don't know already, Boomerangs are little bones that you can shoot and it comes back to you dealing double its damage. It does a lot of damage and it acts as a bow, so it's the perfect Archer weapon. Some people switch over to Archer because of this, but the majority stayed as Mage, since the concept of not being able to clear a big area is pretty foreign to them, and bosses back then were pretty weak, so single target DPS was not as important. Fast forward to Floor 5, where a lot of Berserker items and armor sets were added. Items like the Shadow Assassin set, the Livid Dagger, and the Shadow's Fury are all amazing Berserker weapons, and that made quite a few people switch to Berserker, putting Archer class at its all-time low. Not long after, Catacombs Floor 6 was released. The floor was very challenging for a lot of players since the mobs in the boss room have insane amounts of HP. Mages struggled at the start of the update since they don't have good single target DPS, so player 15H had an idea. He started using Boomerangs to kill the giants. The giants died so fast because of the return ability of the Boomerang as well as the ability to shoot 5 at once. However, he didn't use the Archer class for long because of how good left-click Mage was. Not many people used Archer at that point, until Yorin started using Boomerangs. He could kill Terracottas with ease, gaining hundreds of thousands of combat XP per run, which he could later level up pets and profit millions of coins per run. He could also destroy blood mobs by killing in mid-air, as well as one-shotting the giants. More people caught on, and Boomerang prices started going up. On November 17th, Catacombs Floor 7 was added to the game. This floor is where archers shine. Necron has a ridiculous amount of HP which Boomerangs can shred through with ease. Almost everyone started using Boomerangs, and top parties started running multiple archers. Boomerang prices skyrocketed, and the number of archers are at its all-time high. But it was later found out that running a single archer is better than running multiple archers because of the doubled stats. And not long after, triple swapping was found, where you throw boomerangs out and swap to giant sword and swap to a death bow. With this method, you can one cycle Necron, making archer the best class in the game. Almost all parties ran with an archer, and archer stays as the most popular class right after mage. Fun fact, updates actually get tested. So during master mode testing, Boomerangs were used, and they were a little bit overpowered on bosses. A lot of you guys don't know this, but Boomerangs actually received a shadow nerf. They added a delay on how often you can damage the boss. It shows the damage numbers, but the bosses actually don't take any damage. It was barely noticeable, and Boomerangs were still overpowered. It was until Berserker received an insane buff. Melee hits now do insane amounts of damage, and almost all top archers swapped over to Berserker because of its versatility. You actually need to aim with the Boomerangs as an archer, so people preferred left-clicking on the mob instead. Archer was still pretty good, but a lot of people swapped over to Berserker. Sword swapping finally got patched, and Boomerangs did a fraction of its damage as before. people quickly found a way around it, but it got patched very fast. Boomerangs went on a downward slump after this point. Although 15H found a way by using a voodoo doll and a giant sword, it got patched pretty much instantly. What made this even worse is that you can't even shoot more than one boomerang at once now. Swapping to another bone acts as a sword swap, which makes you deal almost zero damage. That completely killed the class, and Archer is pretty much dead. To this day, boomerangs are still not reverted, but I don't think not being able to shoot more than one boomerang is intentional, so they might revert it in the future. Anyways, not long ago, they added an extremely overpowered bow called the Terminator. It had an Enderman Slayer level 7 requirement and an extremely expensive price tag. The bow costed over 1 billion coins before the recipe change, but now it's around 1.5 billion coins. 15H was the first one to craft a bow and showcase its power. More people caught on to this, and players like Refraction, Deathstreaks, Average Sweat, and more crafted the bow. They described the bow as better than a Hyperion, which made Archer class one of the best classes again. This item single-handedly revived Archer class, but the Archer class will never reach its heights with boomerangs ever again.